Hi, I'm Mel. I'm from the UK and I'm a second year PhD student in the Department of Chemistry here at Imperial College London. We asked Imperial College London followers on Instagram everything that they want to know about doing a PhD. And while there isn't a one answer fits all, every PhD journey is different, I'm here today to answer those questions and give you my personal experience, what it's like doing a PhD in the chemistry department. So let's get started. So the first question is, what made you want to do a PhD? Now this is actually a really common question to be asked in an interview, so definitely make sure you've got a good answer for this one. In my case, it was actually quite simple. I've just always loved science ever since I was a child. And when it came to deciding what I wanted to do for my undergraduate degree, I just knew I wanted to do chemistry. It just intrigued me in a way that I just wanted to learn more and more about it all the time. So it just made sense. And then when it came to applying for jobs and things after university, I really found the idea of doing research quite exciting. Not only are you diving deeper and learning more and more about a subject that you really like, but to be on the cutting edge, to be the person that's like leading the way in your particular field, I just find that really, really exciting, and a PhD is perfect for that. How far in advance should I start talking to supervisors? Now, this really does depend on the type of PhD that you're applying for, and by that I mean if you're applying for a advertised project that's already been thought out, or if you are the person that's proposing a project to work on. So if you're applying for an advertised project, I would, as soon as you see something that you like, I would send an email to that supervisor and set up a little meeting to discuss the project and ask any questions that you might have before you then go on to apply formally. If you are the person that's proposing a project, I would start talking to the supervisors probably one academic year in advance before you would like to start. This basically gives the supervisor some time to see if they have space in their lab for when you would like to start, think about funding and any grants that they might need to apply for, and it also gives you plenty of time to develop that project and write your research proposal. What is the split like between research and lab work? Now, this really does depend on your project and how heavily experimentally based it is. For me personally, my project does rely quite heavily on experimental lab work, so I probably spend about 70% of the time in the lab doing experiments, and then the other 30% of the time doing data analysis, characterization, reading papers, and preparing for presentations and things like that. But yeah, it does depend. Obviously, with a chemistry PhD, you're probably going to be spending more time in the lab, unless you specifically go for a computationally heavy project. How much more work is there than a master's? Now, with a PhD, I kind of view it as kind of like a full-time job. I mostly work Monday to Friday within the hours of 9 to 5. Obviously, there are exceptions to this when the work does pile up a little bit. But the thing with a master's is that not only do you have a research project, but you also usually have all of these additional modules that you need to complete, which mean you have extra assignments and exams which eat into your time. So actually, I find it a lot easier to manage my time while doing a PhD. How do you come up with a research proposal? Now, this is quite a big task and it can be quite daunting, especially if this is the first time that you've ever attempted something like this when you're applying for a PhD. But basically, what a research proposal is putting forward a question that you would like to answer with your research. So to develop this question, what I would suggest is read loads and loads of literature in the field, see what's already out there, what's already been done, what people already know about the subject, and what the limitations currently are. Once you've done this, you can then put all of this into a work plan where you can outline what you are going to do, how you would like to do it, how all of this work will help to answer your original question. When should I apply? Now, this really does depend on the PhD program that you're applying for. In my personal experience, I started in October 2020, but I didn't apply for the position until January 2020 with my interview in March. Now, I actually felt like this was quite late in the application process compared to what I was seeing around me. So I'd probably recommend starting the search one academic year before you want to start the program. How do you fund a PhD? Do you pay or do you get paid? Now, I find with STEM subjects, the PhD is usually funded. When you're applying for PhD projects, it will usually say on the advertisement if there is funding associated with it, and in most cases, there is. If you are awarded funding, then the funding body will pay for your tuition fees, they will pay you a monthly stipend to live on, and they will award you a consumables grant as well to pay for anything that you might need to carry out your research. It's not like a student loan, you don't have to pay it back. If there isn't funding associated with the PhD project, you can apply for funding externally, either through a research council, or you can go for an internal scholarship such as the President's Scholarship at Imperial College. There is also an option to go self-funded. Obviously, this only applies if you are happy to do so and have the means to do so. If you do go self-funded, you will have to pay all of your tuition fees, pay for your living costs while you're doing your PhD, and also for any consumables or anything else you might need during your PhD. How long does a PhD take? This does vary a little bit with the individual project, but usually the limiting factor with the length of a PhD is how long you have the funding for. Funding bodies will usually offer funding between 3 and 4 years, and usually the student will try to finish the PhD within that amount of time. However, every single PhD student has 4 years from the day that they start to finishing the PhD. So even if you only have 3 years of funding, you still have that extra year to submit. Do you find time to enjoy London? Yes, I do actually, and I feel like there's a little bit of a myth that doing a PhD involves doing super long hours, like 12, 16 hour days, and never having time for yourself. But that just isn't true, to be honest. I think it's perfectly reasonable to do a PhD and still be able to find time to yourself and have a good work-life balance. One thing that I personally do is that I always put aside one day of the weekend to do absolutely no work, go out and explore London, do whatever it is that I feel like doing that day, and then the other day of the weekend is kind of a relax and unwind day, and then just prepare a little bit for the week ahead if I need to. But yeah, definitely make sure that you can take time for yourself. I think it's very easy to get swept up in the feeling that things need to be done all the time, but you will thank yourself later when you've properly rested and relaxed, and you don't want to live in London for 3 to 4 years and never see it. Is it worth it? Now, my answer to this question might change depending on when you ask me. Doing a PhD really is a roller coaster, and you do have some weeks that are better than others. Sometimes research just doesn't work out. Sometimes it feels like no matter what you do, nothing is working and you're making no progress. It is really important to remember though that this is a universal experience. Every single PhD student that I've spoken to about this has felt this way at some point or another. Having said that, when things are going well, it's such a great feeling when you have a breakthrough, when things are working out. And aside from the actual research project, I have made some incredible friends, I've met some brilliant people, and I've learned so much while I've been here for the past 2 years. So yeah, I would say it is worth it. It is difficult. It really is difficult, but the reward makes it worth it. Also, being called doctor is a pretty nice bonus too. So that brings us to the end of the PhD Q&A. Thank you so much to everyone for watching, and I really hope that this has been helpful. And yeah, best of luck to everyone who's applying. You've got this.